executive board and the associate chair. First, I want to thank you for your support in putting forward the approval of co-curricular clubs for the 2021 school year. Faculty and staff advise these clubs are eager to begin working with their students. The students are the beneficiaries of the actions of the board. We all know how important these clubs are for our students and their personal, academic, and social growth. I understand the board's frustration about this information regarding club approval. Many of the advisors in these clubs have been dealing with that level of confusion and lack of communication surrounding their operations and approval of the clubs they have applied for or have been inquiring about since the summer. Until this meeting, the understanding left with the faculty and staff has been that there's no guarantee that the clubs will run or be approved. And I hope you can appreciate how confusing that can be. From the time that WHRA met with the board in June for athletics, and throughout the summer, the message about co-curriculars was that it would be approved in late August. When that board meeting came and went, an email from the administration came out that while in itself was confusing and that it indicated that we would need in-person meetings and that there would not be busing for students, the email also indicated that co-curriculars would be approved at the September board meeting. You can imagine, therefore, the surprise from our co-curricular advisors when they received a late Friday email indicating that they would not be board approved. No other explanation, no other communication. When the WHRA reached out over this past weekend to the advisors, they expressed their shock and dismay over not ever being reached out to. None of the advisors felt anyone had asked them how, anyone had asked them how they could run their club in a virtual setting. The few advisors that were lucky enough to have communication at all were never once clued into the fact that decisions to not approve their clubs were happening. Peer leaders, the club not up for approval tonight, already ran meetings and organized students for freshman orientation. Science League and Robotics have heard from their head organizations that they plan to run this year, but no one has reached out and spoken with the advisors to solicit any input. The yearbook advisors emailed questions about the viability of running completely virtual and have heard nothing back. By all accounts of the advisors, everyone was expecting to be board approved at tonight's meeting. And I ask you, where were the discussions that could have taken place with the advisors? Where was the transparency and communication that was talked about with developing strategic plans? Even department supervisors had no idea the decision about co-curricular clubs was not going to be approved. What it comes down to is the advisors of these clubs want to run them and are ready and willing to work to make them happen so that every student can have some outside of the classroom enrichment. So I ask you to please consider approving all the clubs. In addition, the WHREA has emailed you, the board, individual feedback from the co-curricular advisors on the real value and experiences their clubs offer our community's children. In their feedback, you will find strategies and ideas for how to make running these clubs a reality in hybrid learning. Thank you.